Thank you so much, Prashant. And I really thanks to the organizing committee for inviting us for this presentation. Make it very short and simple, and just talking about as a tea and coffee, how can this be as an ingredient? How can this tea and coffee use as an ingredient in the food and beverage industry? Some chemistry occurred, and then we talk about the new product launch happened with the tea and coffee, with the tea. So we look at the coffee, and then we have some discussion on it. Specifically, this we everyone knows about. I just mentioned to start a conversation with everyone. So just we know about tea, different types of the tea on basis of the position. So we have white tea, green tea, black tea, or long tea. And the but people don't know about the catechin it contains. So this is a product contain like, so any green tea contain approximately 30% of the catechins. And these are basically, if you look at the chemistry of the tea are basically, these are all tannins and the polyphenols. And of the classification, these are all the catechins in that. And these catechins are the main responsible for giving all the health benefit to the tea when it comes to. So if you look at the tea, the fundamentally it has like four main components, the functional thing I'm defining it. So it contains antioxidants. So we also mentioned like, okay, if you take a green tea, it's reducing the cancer, it helps in like, various things in the basic metabolism in body, it helps. It's all antioxidants which are playing a major role in the green tea for their applications. We talk about tannins, so we talk about catechins, we'll discuss more. Main thing, all the tea contain caffeine, so the moment I need a cup of a tea or a cup of a coffee because it contains caffeine, which makes you awake. So all the people are using any beverage using tea and coffee, they're either focusing on a caffeine content of it or they're focusing tannin content of it. One fundamental thing also that tea also contains some amino acids. Not all the tea contain this, but there's a certain variety of the tea which contain a threonine amino acid. So this amino acid is known for relaxation in the body. So it goes in very medium level, like it has like some milligrams content of the threonine, as more popular in the matcha tea and the Japanese tea. But this threonine will give mental relaxation to the things. So if you do, okay, I take my tea and certain type of the tea and we make it very soothing and I feel very relaxed and comfortable, this because of this threonine amino acid present in the tea. Because of these active ingredients in the tea, we try to use their property to make that particular product. And this can be wisely used in a product to make the desired claim you're making in a product. This is the basic chemistry of the caffeine. I'm not going much detail of the caffeine and its chemical structure. But this is how the structure of the caffeine look like. Fundamentally, it's an electrolyte. We're talking very simple language, it's very electrolyte. And basically, if you take tea and coffee and chocolate and something, it's present naturally. But you can also make a chemically way of making a caffeine. Now, when you make any claims on a product, which is like more for like a natural claim, a clean label, a friendly label, you try to use a caffeine from the natural source. So you don't add additionally chemically added caffeine in a product. Classical example would be like a Red Bull, market leaders, the big guys. So they add caffeine from a chemical route. But if you want to make something a clean label, like a Ayurvedic or herbal thing, you need to add a green tea or something of that sort of to have the claim. So the caffeine become very important in this space. So how the caffeine impact in the body? Like we know in general caffeine cause awakeness in the body, like it won't let you sleep. And even at dosage of like 6 milligram per body weight per kg, it has an enormous impact. So you see like many of the athletes take the caffeine to boost their stamina or to don't give a fatigue. So this is like very, very critical happen with the caffeine, and it's a grass, it's generally regarded as safe, so you can easily consume the caffeine from the natural source. A lot of studies have been found on the caffeine, like even in the patients or the people with the Parkinson's disease, like even those people after having a caffeine have seen some motions on the motor and the non-motor system are feel about the caffeine. So basically it will give you mental alertness, it will make you active, like if you like a typical 4 PM, you are tired and you still want to work, so the caffeine will help you and make you physically active, maybe like you're not feeling the feel to run it, but at least mentally you become very active, and this is all caffeine is taking a role in this thing. This is one of the key ingredients in the coffee and in the tea, especially we mentioned the green tea, which is more. It's called as anti-gallate catechin and 3-gallate. This is one of the main catechin components, so especially catechin how we talk about. So this is the main component of the catechin in the product, which is like 65% of the catechins in the green tea is basically epigallate, carocatechin, and gallate. this become very critical for anything which when you talk about the catechism per se and the claims on basis of those things. So and it's a good amount, like the BT is the highest among all the ingredients available or the products available in the market. BT contains almost 100 to 200 milligram of EGCG. So it's very, very critical. And but it also contains other minor ingredients which can also help in some other way. So for example, you can theobromine, like it can dilate your throats and you can enhance, you can take more thing inside. Right? So like you can take more air inside. So this is other many things it does. It also has other phenols like gallic acid and other things, but then less quantity compared to the catechins what we referred to here. So one more critical example, like tea also is a preservative. So not many people are really using it directly, but this is what a new trend coming in. So tea extract and catechin are actual natural preservatives. So again, we mentioned this again become a clean label product. Like you don't need to mention as a chemical preservative for like any benzoid or sorbate or anything. You can still mention as a green tea, which has a health benefit and also adding as a preservative. And the best part is completely low cost and it's abundantly applied, so you don't need to worry on the environment for this. Just one small thing, not very relevant to us, but just want to share with you how this really works. So if you see any other preservatives in any product, like you take like artisans or wheatgrass or rosemary extract, which is like widely used these days in a clean label product. And even use this the green tea extract. See the GT1 with rosemary and the green tea extract. This again acts as a very good preservative. So and again this acts as a preservative because of antioxidant contained in the tea and the catechin contained in the tea. So this helps in both the ways. It really helps in reducing the residuity in the product. And it also helps in like whenever there's a microbial phenomena things in the spoilage in the product. So both the way green tea really works as a preservative. Total different approach to the green tea from the industry perspective. People usually like talk about the caffeine in the tea. I just made a small table here just to talk about okay, what are the caffeine contained in the say black tea or brown tea or green tea and how that really happens. Even the herbal tea, like a lot of people we heard about the herbal tea, but there's no caffeine because there's no tea in it. So and when we do decaffeinated, so of course the caffeine level goes down. So we just try to mention the ranges of the product, the per serving, almost like per 30 ml, how much the caffeine would get in the product. So basis this thing, you can actually design your product and talk about okay, if someone take my product as this much ounce as a beverage, then this much caffeine is granted in the product. So this is what we understand the chemistry of it. Now if you see what examples, what industry or people are doing in this domain. So if you see some good trends, what is happening here? So if you see the market from last 5 years, I tried to capture from last 5 years because it's so dynamic market. Really suddenly popping up like from last 2 years. When you see the last 5 years market, the maximum product launch happened, all the new product launch happened, but with the green tea. And also the black tea, but green tea was, people are talking about green tea. This contains green tea. Like even like we've been surprised to see the green tea in a scrub and green tea in a beauty and other things. It's another big domain. I'm not opening that domain as such because we're focusing more on tea and coffee and a food and beverage, but it's widely used across the categories. So again, if you see like how green tea and black tea happen in the natural profile, then so it uses across the category. I'm not saying only one beverage category. It is used in bakery and hot beverages and ice creams. And we see some examples here. We see some examples just to ensure how people are using green tea in ice cream or green tea in snacks or any other beverage. So this is actually widely using it. And if you see all the launches happening, it's more of international data. Thanks to JNPD Mintel, like they had shared this data with me. So if you see green tea product launches happen, is mainly happen in the Western region, also in India, we'll cover that. But mainly Japan is a maximum launch happening. But if you see green tea is not only, we say tea is widely grows in India and Sri Lanka and South Asia, maybe China, but the product happening are seen everywhere. So everywhere in the globe, people talking about a green tea. These are top 10 trend tea extract globally. Like what people use, when we say tea, what comes to people's mind, what they're using it. So by and large, people use a green tea. There's a claim on a black tea or tea extract, white tea extract, different types of the tea people are using it. So we try to capture whatever claim happened on the tea, we try to capture those claims. Sometimes people, an international domain, people don't talk about Ceylon tea as such, but it's very equally important. So the South Asian product will have a Ceylon tea as a tea classification. But generally mentioned as a black tea or a green tea, or people don't have a GI indication, okay, I'm adding Assam tea in my product, and because of my Assam tea, the product is good. It may or may not be, but we try to capture here everything on the tea for the launches. Yeah, this is a fundamental thing. Like, so THC is getting important in healthcare and every other category moving in. So if you see the broader sense, healthcare is still like 7%. So all other product containing green teas is huge. So there's a huge thing happening in the food where you can start adding a tea as an ingredient. So if you look fundamentally, like this is something my perception, and this is we understand something we understand from the people, understand from the market. But what customer is looking at? $1 billion question. Like, nobody knows exactly. But if you look at the fundamental things, what people will look at any end of the product. So they're looking for some functional benefit. They want something extra in every product. I have my tea, but what extra I'm getting in my product? Okay, I'm getting a beverage, but what extra is doing for me? Is it helping me my gut microflora? Is doing some beauty for me? Is doing relaxation for me? Is energy for me? So what is basically that the product is giving to me? And some survey have been done, and we have some data on the survey. This talks about millennial generation. They pay more for when there's a tea and coffee in it. So they are the people who are perhaps reading more in the media, and they understand tea and coffee playing a major role or can do a game change for them. So a lot of people like opt for a tea and coffee. And this is some examples of those in some products. So these are some classical examples which we try to share and understand what Nestle is doing. They make a green tea capsule in Japan. The matcha tea is very, very popular, and they are making some claim on matcha tea. Or they are making plus some snacks or something with the rich in a green tea. This is what has been done. Now we'll see what is happening. So energy drink, what we talk about, is also with the like a green tea. So as we said, people are replacing the caffeine in it and making a good energy beverage with the green tea. This is what again an old history, what Lipton was doing it, but see what people are doing for the gut now. So people are moving right from this immunity boosters tea, now they are moving to a gut thing. Like healthy gut, and you can have again a tea. So tea can again play some role here. We ferment the tea, we do some processing change in the tea, and again it can play a gut role. Tea is a probiotic. It's a very wonderful thing. If you know, like probiotic, like any live bacteria in our on the food system will appreciate, like any live organisms which are active in our intestine, and they're not disturbed any of the bile juice or acids and thing, and they're still active in our intestine, large intestine. They all are the probiotic things. Now tea suddenly got a big thing in a probiotic. Suddenly like a new domain has been opened. And a very wonderful product, kombucha, all this contains fermented product. It has some alcohol. But this is a very, very, very great product which I, again with the tea. It's basically like you take a tea and it's a process of like some 8, 10 days, 12 days technically. And then you ferment the tea with the Saccharomyces cerevisiae, the yeast, and also with the better. And then you again ferment the tea in a controlled condition with the right temperature and oxygen level in that. And you, by fermentation tea, you get a new product which is called the kombucha. And this kombucha has a lot of benefit. Like, and this could be a next big thing happening in the India. This contains 0.5% alcohol. Like to debate whether it comes in excise or not excise. We do think on those regulations perspective. But this becomes very really sort of probiotic. It gives all the green tea benefit. It also like reduces the heart disease and heart disease risk and help in type 2 diabetes. A lot of claims have been happening on the product. Like it's been probiotic, it kills a lot of potential harmful bacteria or the microflora in the intestine, which we don't get rid of it. So and it's very healthy if you consume in a modest quantity. But now, like one interesting thing which we come across, like just attract the eyes, like tea with the rum. So this is only a flavor, by the way. We'll see some more product with that. It's a free of the no alcohol in this particular product. But yeah, tea with the rum flavor. So people want their product, whatever they want to eat or drink daily, or want to have the fun with that, but with the tea. So tea, we usually have a product with the tea flavor. Now we have a rum with the like tea with the rum flavor. So again, some tea trends which we see in India, like. Like Organic India, they have launched some product which will see honey, chamomile, tea, relaxation. I'm sure you have seen this. But what next now? So what people are coming in? So this is another like end product which like we have developed this product, so I can go to the entire history of the product. I just mentioned some samples here just to show you. Like I'm just talking to how the tea can be diversified the entire thing. We were focusing only tea, my tapri wala chai or my ghar wala chai, and now we are taking this to an entire different game altogether. So we all like tend to consume usually tea in a hot format.
like garam garam chai chahiye. Like the fundamental, the USP of chai should be hot. No, that's my USP. So suddenly like the whole game is changing, and this some startup company, they want to serve the tea in a cold format. I'm not talking about iced tea, I'm talking about the regular milk wala tea, like which is coming in a cold format. So then again, like this tea made in a classic format, like plain tea, again a ginger tea, and a cardamom tea. There's some samples here, like if possible, we can share samples to you. But we do serve chilled. Unfortunately, they are not chilled now. But this is what we have done. So I'm just sharing what people have done differently in the things. This is again a ginger one. So we considered the entire project for them, and we made this product for them. Another interesting thing, this is another portion. Like if you're in Mumbai, you can see this product at many of the places. Right from food hall to Nature Basket to all the classic outlets, you can see this product. This is how we have developed this product from one of the startup company. And again, like the whole thing, like we're talking about relaxation and energy. And again, we're adding a tea or some extract in a different way, which can give me this benefit. So I'm not adding a caffeine here, but adding a tea extract, which can give me a caffeine and again making my claim. And this again work equally good in a product. So if you taste the product, you feel like I'm adding my juice, I'm adding my natural ingredient product, herbal product. I won't say Ayurvedic, but more of a herbal or a natural ingredient product. But again, give me the same function, what a chemical caffeine is giving me. So a lot of innovation is happening on this domain. And I'm showing because we are a part of it. Like, I'm not saying a gyan to it, this is what we live with. This again, at Rankini, I was consulting them for their India business operations, for the QA and supply chain and other things. This again, an interesting product came up, Rankini. This, as the name suggests, it talk about relaxation to you. It make you comfortable, relaxed, chilled. Like, and it's not making a good night's sleep drink for you, it's making it like you relax. Like, so much work around here, so much work to do, everyone has like, in a hectic life, how can we really cool ourselves? So have this beverage and we feel cool about it. And the why is happening? This is what their positioning is. What is the hero? Who is Shah Rukh Khan behind it? So that the green tea is what taking a major role. It gives you a theonine because of the theonine content is very high in this particular product. So it gives you relaxation in the mind. So you feel comfortable. So it's the main backbone is again a tea here. Then I'm quickly moving to the coffee. I have some time constraints given to Prashant to me. So I'm just going on the moving from tea to coffee and see what coffee is doing it now. So coffee is very popular, and as far as we could talk more coffee than a tea. I just want to cover very simply, like when you talk about the active ingredients coffee, what we talk about the coffee. So everyone talks about coffee as a caffeine, which we all talk about and which we have somewhat we have covered, so I won't talk on coffee much for the coffee per se. But yeah, it also contains progenic acid, which is again a very active ingredient in the tea. So all the taste you get, the bitterness of the tea or the tea cup, the teacup note and flavor, it's all because progenic acid. It also contains chemically some triterpenes and some other ingredients it also contains. It also contains other minerals like thing. But the main hero or the main the star of the product is a progenic acid. Well, it's nothing of the chlorine, by the way. So it's again an ester of the caffeic acid and chlorinic acid. And it's basically polyphenols. It usually works. And it works in similar function as erythroid in our body, like this caffeine works. And there is like a very, very high amount in a coffee, like it's almost like 12%, 8 to 12% on private basis, the coffee, the unroasted bean coffee will contain. Depends again what source of the coffee is, Arabica or Robusta, the content may be different. But by and large, is one of the main ingredient in a coffee. So like we talk about the tea and coffee separately, I just try to marry both tea and coffee. There's some products internationally which I've seen which contain a both tea and coffee combination. I don't know whether India is ready for it as of now, maybe some more years. But there are certain products which are having both tea and coffee together in a product. Yeah. This is an ice cream, like we talk about people want their own product, but can we have an ice cream with a green tea, an ice cream with a cold brew coffee, or ice cream with my chai latte? So I want to have my own product. These are fundamental things coming to like we see any of the trends, right from a pizza to a burger to a wrap, everything comes to like we, especially we, like I don't say Indian, but as we human people, like we think very differently in a product. We always want to eat what we want to eat, and we change the product basis the need. For example, I want to have my paneer, but I want to have a pizza too. I aspire US, I aspire UK, Europe or something. I want to have a cheese, pizza as a format, but I want a paneer in that. Or I love my aloo tikki. I'm eating aloo tikki fried from ages. I love my aloo tikki, but I want to buy a burger. Like I don't know what about directly. Like I want to buy my own thing. So we have aloo tikki burger. I'm actually McDonald's. I'm sharing this my own understanding. So this thing really helps and It goes everywhere. It's not only focused only to tea or coffee or become an ice cream. So we want the same product, but we need to add some other ingredient which attract to us. And again, when I see this, they're adding tea or coffee in this, they're not adding only as a flavor per se. They're adding some active ingredient in that. So perhaps like for a consumer, it's only on a coffee-flavored ice cream. But he knows that when he's adding a coffee, he's doing a lot of other gimmick in the product. And he's making a good claim on a product. So he's saying, okay, I'm adding an ice cream with a low fat, but I'm having a green tea in it, which further reduces the fat in the body. It added more antioxidant in the product. So all such claims happen like that. There's another company, Indonesian company, and they're adding a durian. Yeah, it's all Indonesian. So they're adding a fruit in a coffee. Yeah. Again, tea in a gut health, coffee in a gut health. Mental research happened, Thai adult, this was specifically a Thai product which we have tried to cover here. And they mentioned people talk about a lot of beauty and their gut health in Thailand and perhaps Southeast Asia. And so they're having a product which having these benefit with the coffee. So taking coffee and a gut health. It's another interesting product Coffee Addict. This again we have developed 2 years back for one company and you were talking more of a convenience per se. I just mentioned here because coffee is talking everywhere now. So it's a nice Starbucks cold coffee you can carry anytime with you, but this is an Indian version of that which we have developed. Interestingly, we talk about all the whey protein supplements and bodybuilding and other things. It's another product like a whey protein supplement developed by Chirag is sitting right there. It's his product and he's just helping him out in development. And it's again a coffee flavored product. So the box are here and perhaps if Chirag permits, I can show samples to you. And so this again a coffee a flavored product, but I'm not saying coffee is the only flavor because when I say strawberry flavor, it's a strawberry flavored product. When I say coffee, I need to add coffee in it. And the moment I add coffee in it, my all active ingredients or all functions of the coffee happening in a product. So the fundamental difference between only a coffee tea and with the other fruit flavors, people will still be happy with adding NI flavor or synthetic flavor or vanilla or any other fruit, but coffee need to add some coffee to get those claims. Some good trends we try to learn globally what happening in the coffee domain. Some interesting thing we found, what people are doing differently now. So coffee is everyone understand is good, caffeine is all good, chlorogenic acid is good. What people are doing differently in the coffee? So we try to capture that particular part. Or what people new trend coming? This is 2019-20 with the trend expected again a Mintel JPD data what they foresee could be new trend. More for a global market, more for a European market, but can be in the market. India is not very far. Some other people at least in Metro will make up such product in future. We never know. So they're adding some liquid nitrogen in our coffee and this gives natural creamy effect to the product. So is that in a cold coffee or can you say a cold brew? And again, you're adding a liquid nitrogen, taking the coffee to a totally different domain. Right? So Starbucks has actually done some work on it in very few stores and few markets. But never know. I won't be surprised if CCD comes with this product in future. Never know. So what people are doing different is again a mental data and it's a 2017 food service data. Some trends which they have shared. And we talk about environmental things and Indian government, we all talk about the environment and everything over plastic we talk about, okay, let's reduce the plastic, reuse it. All those things we talk about, environmental friendly things. Now, people using same analogy for the coffee. When we do the coffee manufacturing, we have all the coffee cherries which are fermented and then we take the beans, the green beans and again processing happen on the things. Now when the coffee is still in a cherry format, that time you do fermentation, so you need a lot of mucilage from the cherry. Now what happened to that? Can we do something on those front? So people are actually taking that waste, so-called waste in that time and working on that and using the skin of the coffee and doing something on it and again making some product out of it. So suddenly people are thinking from holistically entire coffee is happening. So again, we are using our understanding on environment from one side and putting it on the other side. There shouldn't be any wastage anywhere in the matrix. Yeah, so there's another interesting thing I just want to highlight here. So that the blue bottle coffee, they also mix this cascara to the butter and make a cascara butter toast, a coffee with a toast, butter note in it. Butter with a coffee note in it. And again, a waste product for them. It's again a new wave and processing happening. So whatever we mentioned here, the base product, from taking the waste product and fermenting it, and the way they want to ferment in their own way. Because a lot of, if you see back what research people have done, and all my friends here would know, like we would talk about the coffee and like in the roasting, like is it Italian roast, is a mild roast, or is a dark roast. So we talk about coffee in those ways. We talk coffee maybe in Arabica or a Robusta, or we talk the coffee in particle size, like an RNG or a filter coming. Now again, people have done differently. What I can make my difference to the coffee? Or if I want to launch a new coffee, what difference I can make in my coffee? So they talk about the fermentation of the product. So during the fermentation process of the thing, before the roasting, how the product can behave. People talk about those things. And the aging become a new thing in the coffee. We talk only in wines in aging, or in rice in aging perhaps, not talking about coffee in aging. Yeah, this is what a thing perhaps everyone will love in India, like, I don't know, so coffee with a booze. So like, it's a funny concept, but this is what like, one third of the US customers, and all the like, all the millennium generation, or all the like, early 20s talking about adding coffee in their daily alcohol. So if you see like, the survey happened in like US nowadays, they check all the bartenders, what is the most preferred thing what the customer asks them. So they mentioned like one third of people ask for the coffee in their alcohol. So this is again a different consumption style of other things. Like when I've heard stories like people take the Red Bull and add in their alcohol. So this may be like when a caffeine impact, but this is having actually a coffee extract or coffee thing in your booze and making it. So this is what like the basic scenario is happening, and this is the ingredient or the active ingredient present in the tea and coffee. You're changing the entire product, and that's how you can make a claim. So, yeah, that's it for today. If you have any questions, I would love to answer.